Good morning, one and all dear students. Today in this session on the exam topic, going further ahead, we are going to discuss today is ISO enzymes. Regarding the ISO enzymes, they are also important because there are different types of enzymes are there. ISO enzyme stands whenever the two enzymes which have the same catalytic activity, but structurally, physiologically, and rest of all the characteristic feature can be different. So when you define the isoenzymes, it is a certain enzymes may exist in same species, same tissue, same cell, in one or more forms which have same catalytic activity, but are differ physically, chemically, immunologically, electrophoretically, are known as isoenzymes or isozymes. Both the words can be used interchangeably. So isoenzymes, if you want practical example, what are the actually the isoenzymes are? Say for example, your batch is there. Say for example, today you are here to have the knowledge regarding the enzyme topic. And so all the students have come here. Every student, they are different. They are physiology, chemically, or by the nature point of view, all the other behavioral properties, they are different from each other. But the only purpose to come here is to know the biochemistry or to know the enzyme topic properly. So the isoenzymes are also same. They also have the same catalytic property, but physically, chemically, immunologically, and electrophoretically, they are comparatively when they compare with each other, these types of enzymes, they are different, but catalytic activity is same. So any two enzymes which are having the same catalytic property, but physiological and rest of all the parameters or rest of all the physical characteristics are different, in that case, they are said to be the isoenzymes. Here in this, I have included two examples. One is the lactate dehydrogenase, and another one is a creatine phosphate or creatine kinase or creatine phosphokinase, CPK or CK. They can be used one and the same. Both the terminology are one and the same. The lactate dehydrogenase is the source is the heart, muscle, and liver. The reaction it carry out the pyruvic acid is converted to the lactic acid in the presence of LDH, and it is a irreversible type of reaction. Actually, the LDH depending upon the, their physical properties. Here, we are going to discuss in detail regarding the LDH. LDH has got, if you take the all the forms of the LDH forms and we run into onto the electrophoretic chamber, you will be after the attachment of cathode attachment, anode attachment, electrophoretic, that all the circuit is completed and it is run for a specific given time. After the complete running and after the densitometric appearance, you will be able to see the LDH is a tetramer made up of two types of polypeptide. One is M and another one is H types. And due to that, it is after the complete electrophoretic run, you will be having five bands, LDH5, LDH4, LDH3, LDH2, LDH1. The farthest going is the LDH1, then subsequently is the LDH2, LDH3, LDH4, and LDH5. LDH5 will be, which will on the electrophoretic run, it will be having, it has crossed least distance from the cathodic end. So electrophoretic property of all the LDH sub types has got different electrophoretic properties, because it is made up of two different types of polypeptide chains. When you compare the composition, when you study the composition of the all the isoenzymes forms of the LDH, it will be having a different compositions. LDH1, it will be having all the polypeptide chains of the H type, and it is located in the heart and RBCs, and it is diagnostic point of view, it is seen in the myocardial infarction. LDH2, 3 H type and 1 N type, heart and RBC, it is observed, and it is significant whenever there is a megaloblastic anemia. So so comparative concentration of LDH2 is more in the RBCs rather than only into the heart. LDH3, it has having two H type and one M type, two M types polypeptide chains are there, and it is more located into the brain, and it is significant in the leukemia and malignancy. LDH4, it is having a three M types of polypeptide and one H type of polypeptide chain. It is more located in the lung and spleen. So pulmonary infarction, in case of pulmonary infarction, it has got a diagnostic importance. LDH5, all the four polypeptide chains are only of M types, and it is more to the muscle and liver. So whenever there is a muscle damage or liver disease, the measurement of this enzyme can be significant. When you compare the all the LDH forms, the normal range of the LDH is 62 to 50 international units per liter, and it is significant elevation of LDH1 and LDH2 occurs within 24 to 48 hours of the myocardial infarction, because first two isoenzyme forms of the LDH1, they are more located into the heart muscle. In acute viral hepatitis, LDH4 and LDH5 are predominantly increased. So depending upon the type of tissue, the different isoenzyme form concentration can be different. And that property of different isoenzymes with a differential concentration in different tissue can be used diagnostic point of view depending upon the type of isoenzyme present in that specific tissue. The LDH5 is increased in the breast and carcinoma, breast carcinoma, prostatic carcinoma, and malignancy of the central nervous system. LDH2 and LDH3 increased in the leukemia. Creatinine phosphokinase source skeletal muscle, brain, small amount in the lungs. In human tissue, CK exists in the three different isoenzymes forms, and it has got, each isoenzyme is a dimer that are made up of two types of the polypeptide chains, which may be either M or B type, or brain type. M stands here for the muscle, and B stands for the brain. It has got three types. CK1, it is only contains B types of polypeptide, and it is more concentrated in the brain and neurological injury. It has got diagnostic importance. CK2, it is a CKMB, also labeled as a CKBM or CKMB. It is more concentrated in the heart, and it is very, very significant whenever there is a chances of the myocardial injury or myocardial infarction. CK3, it has got both the polypeptide chain of the M type, and it is more into the skeletal muscle, and so muscular dystrophies and myopathies, its concentration might be increased. The clinical significance, normal range is in the male 12 to 100 international units per liter, in the female 10 to 80 international units per liter. It is, in case of males, it is comparatively higher because of the higher muscle mass in case of males, and it is less in case of females because they has got less muscle mass. Marked increase in the AMI and muscle dystrophy is seen. Moderate increase in the muscle injury and the hypothyroidism type of clinical diseases or clinical condition, the concentration can be appear in the bloodstream. Another topic which is clinically very important, that is alloenzymes. Alloenzymes, comparatively, they are different from the isoenzymes. Isoenzymes are the enzymes having same catalytic property but different physical and chemical properties. Whereas alloenzymes are variant forms of the enzymes which differ structurally but not functionally from other alloenzymes coded for by the different alleles at the same locus. So here is the important point here is that they are located at the same locus. So alloenzymes are also called as allozymes, are variant forms of the enzymes which differ structurally but not functionally from other alloenzymes coded for by the different alleles at the same locus. These are opposed to the isoenzymes, which are enzymes that perform the same function but which are coded by the genes located at a different loci. So alloenzymes functionally might be same, but structurally differ structurally, but they are synthesized by the same allele at the same locus. Whereas isoenzymes, they are catalytically or functionally, they might be same, but they are coded by the different loci, on the different loci of the DNA molecule. Alloenzymes exist high levels of functional evolutionary conservation throughout the specific phyla or and kingdoms. So used by the scientist as molecular markers to assess the evolutionary histories and relationships between the different species. So this can be the clinically, not just for the clinical point of view, but evolutionary point of view, these alloenzymes might have some important significance. Alloenzymes exhibit high levels of functional evolutionary conservation throughout the specific or throughout that phyla or kingdoms. So used by the scientist as a molecular marker to assess evolutionary histories and relationship between the different species. So it might be related to the that clinical point of view, medicinal or surgical point of view, it might have a little bit less significance. But evolution point of view, we can study it properly. We can study the different species. And by studying the alloenzyme forms of different species, we can say that that this species might have evolved from the that type of species. So in between the understanding the relation between the different species can be understood properly by studying the alloenzymes in deep. They can be separated by capillary electrophoresis because they are chemically and physiologically, they are different. These enzymes generally perform very basic functions found commonly throughout all the life forms, such as the DNA polymerase, the enzyme that repairs the copies and DNA. So all these enzymes, DNA polymerase, that is required for all the for central dogma procedure or central dogma process. Their study can also reveal important findings different in between the different species. So this is the significance of the alloenzymes. So along with the isoenzymes, alloenzymes are equally important. It might be have less importance in case of the medicine point of view or surgical point of view or clinician's point of view, but evolutionary point of view, they have got more significance. And comparison with the isoenzyme is that alloenzymes, they are functionally same, but physical properties, chemical properties might be different, but they are evolved from the same locus of the DNA. Whereas isoenzymes, they are physically or functionally, they might be same, but rest of all the properties are different. And along with that, one more difference is that they are synthesized by the different loci on the DNA. Now coming to the another important subtopic of the enzyme is the diagnostic clinical application of the enzymes. Actually, enzymes are present. Discussed this so many times that of different types of enzymes, all the enzymes are not present in equal concentration in all the types of tissues. For example, OTP, AST and ALT, these enzymes are more present in the liver. Some concentration also present in the myocardial tissue. Some and in the myocardium, CKMB is a specific, that specific enzyme is also present. So in a different organs or different tissues, different concentration of the enzymes is there. Different concentration of the enzymes are there. And this property of a differential concentration of a different enzymes in the different tissues can be utilized a diagnostic point of view. Say, for example, here, the very first enzyme is acyl phosphatase. Normal range is 0.4 to 4 King Armstrong units per deciliter. And it is clinically significant when you have prostatic cancer, Gaucher's disease, Paget's disease, and thrombocytosis. So in the prostate, it has got higher concentration in this condition. So, and so in that, in so respectively, it has got that diagnostic importance. Aspartate transaminase, AST, also labeled as SGOT, it is significant even though there is myocardial infarction. AST rises in first 12 hours and it get up to peak, reaches to peak in about 24 hours and value falls near about on the fourth or fifth day of the myocardial infarction. So AST is more concentrated into the myocardial tissue. That's why it can be used a diagnostic point of view whenever there is a chances of myocardial infarction. Then alanine aminotransferase, ALT or SGPT, it is more concentrated in the liver. So whenever there is a pathology related to the liver, say for example, liver diseases, jaundice, cirrhosis of liver, the concentration of ALT get raised. Aldoses in muscle diseases like muscular dystrophy, dermatomyositis, it may increase. Alkaline phosphatase, it is increased in the obstructive jaundice, infective hepatitis, liver cirrhosis, bone diseases, rickets, osteomalacia, and so on. Amylase, it is a digestive enzyme. It is synthesized by the pancreatic tissue. So it is increased in the whenever there is damage to the related to the salivary glands or pancreas, acute pancreatitis, mumps, obstruction in the pancreatic duct, peptic ulcer, intestinal obstruction, and it is decreased in the liver diseases and diabetes mellitus. So depending upon the type of tissue, it can be used significantly. Cholinesterase in organophosphorus insecticide poisoning, it is used as a marker. Gamma glutamyl transferase in alcoholism, hepatobiliary disease, it is increased. 5' prime nucleotides, hepatitis, and obstructive jaundice, it is increased. Prostate-specific antigen, it is increased in the prostate cancer. So in this way, the different enzymes can be used a diagnostic point of view, and it can be also not just for the diagnostic point of view, it can be used for the follow-up studies or follow-up cases for the during the treatment of the patient. Now, next use of the enzymes is therapeutic use of the enzymes. Therapeutic means for the treatment point of view. As the enzymes carry out the so crucial functions in the body, that function can be used for the therapy, for the treatment point of view. Here, example is asparaginase obtained from the bacterial source is used in the treatment of patients of the some of the types of the leukemias. Then chemotrypsin used for the dissolving ligaments of the lens during the extraction of the cataract. They also used as the inflammation healing of a fracture. Then penicillinase, which can be used to whenever there is a problem, any patient with the penicillin toxicity or penicillin anaphylactic reaction, you can give the penicillinase enzyme so that it will demolish the effect of the penicillin. Then lysosomes, this is found in the human tears and is used for the treatment of the eye infection, because in the eye infection, bacterial infection, it can kill that bacteria because it has got lysosomal properties. Trypsin, it is a proteolytic enzyme used, which is used to clean the wounds and infected burns and skin and ulcers. Along with that, streptokinase can be used in the AMI patients and the thrombosis. Streptokinase, it kills the thrombus. So it can be used for the acute myocardial infarction. And whenever there is thrombosis, pulmonary thrombosis, pulmonary embolism, in that condition, you can use, you can do the streptokinase as a thrombolytic agent. Then hyaluronidase, it used in the, as a spreading factor in many injection. It is also helpful in the transport of the sperm. Fibrinolysin, it is used in the venous thrombosis, pulmonary and arterial embolism. Then renin, it is used in the gastric achalia. And lipase, it is used in the GIT disorders and chronic pancreatitis. So it is an endless number of uses are there, not just diagnostic, but also therapeutic also. So these are the only I have compiled them, and only the 10 uses I have mentioned here. So enzymes can be used for the therapy, for the treatment point of view, and it has been become the crucial for so many clinical conditions and so many, and it has been found to be a life-saving for so many clinical or legal conditions, which can lead to the death of the patients, in that they have found to be very, very crucial. Another use, the analytical uses. Analytical uses means apart from the diagnostic and therapeutic, it can be used for the research point of view, for the industrial point of view. Enzymes are widely used in the foods, pharmaceutical and chemical industries. Example, pectinase in the food industry, amylase in the textile industry. In washing powder, enzymes are incorporated to remove stains from the clothes. Penicillin acylase is used to convert the semi-synthetic penicillin. lactase is used to hydrolyze the lactose, as the lactase acts on the lactose and there is production of the glucose and galactose. So for industrial point of view, they are used. The depending upon the what type of that enzyme having the, that catalytic activity, that catalytic activity can be utilized for the industrial and research purposes. That these are nothing but analytical uses. Enzymes can be used as reagents and labels. Commonly used in label enzymes are glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase, alkaline phosphatase, and peroxidase. Enzymes can be used in the clinical laboratory as reagents for the estimation of the biochemical parameters. Example, glucose oxidase and peroxidase, glucose alcohol dehydrogenase, ethanol and lactose dehydrogenase, lactate dehydrogenase for the lactose. So enzymes not only used for the industrial research, but for estimation of various parameters, they can be utilized. As mentioned here, glucose oxidase for measuring blood glucose level, diagnosis of the diabetes mellitus, enzyme linked immunosorbent assay ELISA, detecting the various viruses in the body fluids, or for example, diagnosis of the AIDS viruses in infection. So in this manner, there are so many purposes which can be very well carried out by the use of the enzymes in the analytical or for the research or for the industrial point of view. And they have found very, very crucial here also. Now, enzymes in the myocardial function. here creatine kinase, which is increased after this graph depicting the serine enzyme activity on the y-axis and days after the onset of the chest pain on the x-axis. Here in the myocardial infarction, or whenever there is a problem with the myocardial tissue, these are creatine kinase, then AST and ALT, LDH, they can be used for the diagnostic point of view, and not just for diagnostic point of view, also it is can be used to assess the follow-up studies whenever that a patient is under the treatment of for the myocardial infarction. CK is increased within first 24 hours of the onset of the myocardial infarction, and it remains it near about to the 2 to 3 days. And before the end of the 3 days, it goes down to the baseline level. AST also increased within first day of the myocardial infarction, and it remains in the blood near about 4 to 5 days. And it is this is in case of the AST. And in case of LDH, it increased after first 24 hours, and it remains into the bloodstream near about 7 days. This is for the myocardial infarction. Going ahead, other than enzymes, we can utilize myoglobins, then total CK, then CKMB, then troponin T, along with the EST, then LDH and CKMB. These myoglobins and troponin I can be also utilized for diagnostic point of view. They are not the enzymes, but can be utilized. It is just for information I mentioned here. These are the enzyme markers raised in the whenever there is pathology to the liver. AST and ALT, they are increased along with the bilirubin. Yes, bilirubin is not an enzyme, but it is raised whenever there is pathology related to the liver tissue. And AST, ALT, they are the markers of the enzymatic activity within the. Sorry. AST and ALT, they are the important enzyme markers whenever there is a damage to the liver tissue. Next, in this session, actually, this topic. I am doing it as a homework for you all. The antioxidant enzyme system, the superoxide dismutase, then catalase, then glutathione peroxidase, and glutathione reductase. These are the important enzymes which are used as antioxidant in the human body. And many of the times, the questions have been there on the antioxidant enzymes in the human body. So go through it and come with prepared next time. This is how, what is the effect of the superoxide dismutase? It kills the superoxide, it converts the superoxide to hydrogen peroxide and O2. And this is the first line of defense to protect cells from the injurious effect of the superoxide. It converts the superoxide and to the H2O2, which is comparatively less toxic. And this H2O2 is taken by the catalase and converted to two molecules of the H2O and one molecule of the oxygen. Then glutathione peroxidase, it detoxifies H2O2 to the H2O, while reduced glutathione is converted to oxidized glutathione, and the enzyme glutathione reductase utilizing NADPH, the HMP shunt is the major source of the NADPH. This is in detail given here. This is a reduced glutathione. It takes up the H2O2 and convert to the two molecules of water, and glutathione peroxidase along with the selenium is used, and there is formation of oxidized glutathione. And oxidized glutathione in the presence of the riboflavin, that is FAD as a coenzyme, it takes up the also the NADPH plus H, that is a reduced form of the NADPH, NADP, which is obtained from the HMP shunt and utilized to convert the oxidized glutathione to the reduced glutathione. When reduced glutathione actually converts the hydrogen peroxide to the water molecule, so avoiding the excessive presence of the water on that H2O2 and converting to it to the less toxic form, that is in the water form. Now, last portion, last section of the enzyme topic is the units of the enzyme activity. Enzymes are not expressed in milligram or microgram and it is expressed in the form of the activities. The enzyme activity expressed in many ways, like King Armstrong units, Somogy units, Rettmann and Frankel units, spectrophotometric units, but they are not uniform all over the world. But so for that, the International Units of Union of Biochemistry, they have invented one unit called as a CATL. And CATL is to maintain the uniformity in the expression of the enzyme activity. The Enzyme Commission of IOB has suggested new unit CATL, abbreviated as a CAT. One CAT denotes the conversion of one mole substrate per second. Mole per second. Internal units, SI unit system, international or simply enzyme units, is conversion of one micromole of the substrate per minute. So these are the two units, CATL and international units. They are most of the times used internationally, and most of the times they are followed all over the world. Students, we stop here for today's, and this is the final lecture on the topic, that is enzyme. Thank you all of you for kind listening.